मास्टर ऑफ ग्लोबल मैनेजमेंट प्रोग्राम एट रॉयल रॉट्स यूनिवर्सिटी ब्रिटिश कोलंबिया इज वन ऑफ द बेस्ट प्रोग्राम्स फॉर कनाडा स्टडी वीजा। इफ यू आर लुकिंग फॉर ए मास्टर्स डिग्री इन ए पब्लिक यूनिवर्सिटी विद 3 years ऑफ पीजी वर्क परमिट, दिस प्रोग्राम कैन बिकम ए रियली रियली ग्रेट ऑप्शन फॉर यू। टू नो ऑल द डिटेल्स अबाउट दिस प्रोग्राम एंड टू क्लियर ऑल ऑफ योर डाउट्स, वॉच दिस वीडियो टिल द एंड। Hello everyone, welcome back to this YouTube channel, The Immigration Gurus. This is Tender Brower, Resource Scholar, ETS Montreal, Canada. To apply with me, you can ping me on my WhatsApp number 9812380882. My numbers are given on screen as well. You can ping me on my WhatsApp to proceed further with me. In this video, I am sharing a really good program, that is Master of Global Management at Royal Roads University, Victoria, British Columbia. And I am going to share all the details about the program, including what is the eligibility criteria, how to apply, who can go for this program, and how this program can help you in building your career, and how this program can help you in getting 3 years of PG work permit, what kind of versions are available, and how to apply for this program as well, and everything. So in this video, I'm going to cover everything. So stay tuned till the end. To start with the location. So the location is Victoria, British Columbia. Earlier, initially, approximately 1 year back, I knew about this university, but I was not really keen to go there because I felt that this university might be really remote. It is in Victoria. I don't know how to reach and all those stuff. But when students are going there, my students are going there. So now I am a lot more confident, and their jobs and everything, location wise, everything is really good. Actually, this looks like a remote place, and there you need to go through a ferry from Vancouver to Victoria. You can go through a ferry, but it is fine. You can reach there easily, and you can get full-time work, part-time work there as well. So it becomes a really good location in that sense, because everything is available at this location. Bank is also there, and all type of facilities are there at the that location as well. There is one more university, University of Victoria is also there in Victoria. So these two big universities are there, and Royal Roads University is offering Master of Global Management, which becomes a really good option to go if you want to go to British Columbia, and if you want to reach Canada anyway. It is a Master of Global Management program, which is a master's degree, and it comes up with two versions. There is one version where you have to study 12 months. This is just the coursework, and you just complete your coursework and get your PG work permit and proceed. This is one version. Second version is there in which you can have 6 months of internship, and that internship is really good because ultimately it is helping you in completing 1.5 years of program, which will give you 3 years of PG work permit. You need not to pay much amount for this internship period. The fee I'm going to discuss later. So you need not pay much amount for this internship period. This is going to be like your job. So you are doing job for 6 months, and for that, it is allowing you to get 3 years of PG work permit. And it also gives you the buffer to apply for spouse open work permit as well, because your total visa period will be 16 plus 3, 19 months, and it is good enough period to apply for your spouse open work permit and go get the spouse visa as well. Also, this program, why I really recommend this program, because there are so many MBA programs available, but Master of Global Management is a different kind of program, and it is not easily available in our home countries, especially in developing countries. So for MBA, it can be said that it is easily available in your home country. Why you are spending this much of money in Canada to get an MBA? Because you can easily do it in India, China, or whatever country you are in. So MBA is easily available, but Master of Global Management is not easily available. So it becomes a really better program than MBA if you are getting admission in this program. What kind of backgrounds can go for this program? So if you are having HR background, sales background, business background, finance background, wherever you can become a global manager or global business manager or any kind of business related roles, if you are having that kind of roles, then this program can become in operations as well. This program can become a really, really good option to go to, because it is a master's degree. It improves your visa chances. It is in a public university, which is Royal Roads University. So everything is really good about the program, and the fee is also good. So I am discussing the fee part as well very soon. Then coming to the eligibility. So many times we feel that we may not be eligible for the master's degree. It is really hard to get admission and all those stuff. So we don't really look for this kind of options. We do not even look for MBA options as well when our percentage is a bit on lower side, or we have so much of study gap. So many times we try to go to colleges like Global Business Management. There are so many options. St. Clair is there, Conestoga is there. We go for those type of options after experience, and many times it leads to rejection because going to a college with a mature case is getting visa is always difficult. So in those kind of scenario, this becomes a really great option to get visa. If you are going for a master's degree in a public university, it shows that you have really great learning ability and you are going for a really great program going to university. It establishes your bona fide studentship as well. So I usually recommend going for project management because that is a different program. So rather than going for MBA, I usually try to go for project management if you are eligible to get admission. So rather than going to some private university, I'm not going to take names. So it is better to go to a public university where you are getting admission in project management. So right now with Algoma, as the problem is going on with admission and we are not getting the clarity. So now for non-technical backgrounds, we are looking for other options. And this has become a really good option for us because we have already secured admission for many students there. And now the timeline is also really quick. I'm going to tell the timeline as well. So the admission criteria is also really flexible, really good, not flexible. So you require 6.5 band, no less than 6 in IELTS. So IELTS score in writing and speaking, you require 6.5 band. And in other two modules, you require 6 and 6 band. So 6.5, no less than 6 is not really high score. You can easily get this score for PG level and you can get secure your admission in RRU. Sometimes it happens that you do not have this kind of IELTS score available. In that case, you can go with Duolingo as well. In Duolingo, if you are scoring 115 in all modules, then you are good to go for admission and you can take Duolingo test at home. And it is perfectly fine to secure your seat with Duolingo. And you can use your IELTS score, either IELTS Academic or GT, if you are applying under SDS category. And if you are applying from non-SDS countries, in that case, you can use IELTS Academic for your study visa application. So Duolingo has become a really good option to secure admission in RRU and many other universities as well. Percentage, again, we many times say that we have 10 years of experience, our percentage that time was not really good or something. RRU can even give you admission with 60%, 55% as well. I have already done a case where the person secured admission with 50% as well. So it is possible to secure admission with less percentage. I would say that if you have 60% marks, 65% marks, you have a really good chance of getting admission in RRU. So you can look for this program rather than going for global business management in college or something, or international business management in some college. So better than that, if you are a mature profile, always look for this program because it will improve your visa chances to great extent. Also, GMAT and GRE is not required, so don't worry about it. Whatever options, there are so many MBA options as well. I made a live on that as well. So there are so many MBA options, Master of Global Management, this option is always also there, where you do not require GMAT or GRE. There are so many public universities where you can secure admission in master's degree, MBA and MGM, where you do not require any GMAT or GRE. So don't worry about it. Then what kind of documents are required? So the list of documents is quite sophisticated. They require two LORs from your current company or the previous companies. So the two professional LORs are required. So I usually ask people to prepare them because if I'm going to write LORs for everyone, so they may have similar content, and you must not write same content for your admission, neither in SOP nor in LORs. So be careful in that. I can share the samples to all my students, but I ask them to take reference and write LORs on your own. So there is specific method of writing LORs that I usually recommend. And after writing LORs, two LORs are required. Your referees can send LORs directly to university. So it is possible. So it can be flexible. It can be through email as well. So there is no fixed kind of criteria that you have to take sign or something. In COVID time, it is not required. They can simply send those LORs directly to RRU and they are perfectly accepted. Then VES is required. Now, there are two things. They require either VES. If you have done VES already, that is course evaluation, then in that case, you can extend your VES to make it course to course evaluation. And it takes $100 for the extension and $30 extra to send that result directly to RRU. So that is one good option where you are going to save time. If VAS is not done by you, in that case, you can pay directly to RRU $130, I guess. They will evaluate your degrees by themselves. So it is also possible. The application fee for RRU is $130 approximately. And if you are going to do evaluation through VAS, then you can directly send your course-to-course evaluation from VAS to RRU. So that is one way. Or you can pay that money directly to RRU and they can also evaluate your degrees. So there are two methods, but overall your cost is going to be approximately $260 as the application fee, which involves $130 application fee and rest of the amount for course-to-course evaluation of your degrees. So you need to send your degrees either through VAS, or you can do, and that is a better and quicker method, or you need to do it, you need to send it directly to RRU. Next thing is SOP. SOP is also a crucial part. It is quite really a great structure. They have a great structure of SOP. It has four parts. You need to cover all the parts for SOP. And I usually help my students, my candidates to write the right SOP. We have all the references available. We give them sample and they prepare it accordingly. I check it and we submit the SOPs in that way. Then educational documents, normal, those are required. Then you require to prepare your resume in a good manner as well. So there should not be any gaps available, gaps in your resume. You need to give proofs for everything, whatever you are saying that you have so-and-so certification, you need to give proofs for everything. And then in your job, in your jobs, you need to mention your job duties as well. You need to mention the kind of, is it a full-time job, part-time job, how many number of hours you are working there. And also the link of website and any email ID or some place to reach your company. So you need to provide those type of things as well. So it is quite a format given by them, and we give the sample as well for that so that you can prepare it easily. So that's how the process is. So preparing documents, it takes time, but all those process, all these efforts are worth because of the visa success rate of this program and for RRU as well. So this program is a really great program in that sense. Then there are three intakes available. One, first is September intake, which is the largest intake, and it takes the most time to give you offer letter. So take the time period after the submission of the application is 3 months for September intake, because it is highly competitive, but many people do not know or do not apply for this this program, but still it is highly competitive and they take a lot of time, at least 3 months to give you offer letter. And for other intakes, it is quite quicker. Recently, we got admission in 40 days as well for January intake. So for Jan and May intake, it is far quicker compared to September intake. September intake has lot many applications compared to January and May intake. And May intake, so timeline can vary from 40 days, 30 days, 40 days to 3 months. So this much of time is required. Mostly for September intake, it takes longer. For other intakes, it takes shorter time. And right now, the applications are open. For Jan intake, you can apply till 10th of October and you can secure your admission for January intake. And now the admissions are far quicker. And I guess if you are going to submit your application now, by the end of October, everything should be done and you should be able to apply for your visa in the first week of November, and you can proceed for it. Coming to the fee, fee for this program, total fee is $34,000. If you are going for 1.5 year option, where internship, 6 months of internship is involved. So 3 semester of study coursework and 1 semester of 6 months of internship, wherever you want to go, you can do that internship. So if you want to go to any other province for your internship, you can go there, you can complete your internship and you can complete your degree in RRU, it's not a problem. So you can do your internship anywhere. And it can help you in getting job as well later on, full-time job. So it is really a great option because the internship option of 6 months is available. Now, coming to the fee, for first year, you need to pay $30,000. Yes, it is the first year fee is $30,000. And for second year, for internship period, it is just $4,000. Now, you may feel that $30,000 for first year is a really big amount, but it is kind of a blessing in disguise. Because if you are paying $30,000, you have paid approximately the entire fee of the program. And if you have already paid the entire fee, if you are paying $10,000 GIC as well, it's all done. Visa officer cannot question how you are going to pay the second year fee. There is no second year fee. It is just $4,000 and no one can question your financial capacity in that sense. So if you are able to pay $30,000 fee, and even if you can go a step ahead, if you can pay $34,000 fee, means complete program fee, because you need to pay just $4,000 more. If you can pay $34,000 fee, you have paid the entire fee. Visa officer cannot question your financial capacity in that sense. It is all over. You need not to pay anything for second year. You need not to pay anything for your expenses in Canada. You are paying $10,000 GIC and it's all done. So it is kind of a really great thing if you can afford $30,000 and if you can pay the entire fee for this program, it is a really great thing because it can improve your visa chances to a great extent. But if you are applying in non-SDS, then you can pay like $20,000, $50,000, $15,000 as well. But I would recommend to pay entire fee $30,000 for at least first year. Or if you are able to pay, then pay $34,000 as well. That will be a better case. Visa success rate, I have already shared all the points why the visa success rate can be great. Because MGM is not available everywhere. It is always better to go for a university, public university, master's degree, global management program, which is not available everywhere. So it is going to improve your visa chances. Of course, your SOP is a great thing that I make for my students all the time. So that is an important document. Just securing admission is not enough. So if you are going to make right SOP for visa application, if you are attaching right documents, if you are going for this right program, and in that case, you should get your visa. Even though your age is 35 or even above, it will improve your visa chances to a great extent. So visa success rate with this program is really high. Also, sometimes they can have kind of foundation programs. They specifically do not call it a foundation program, but they are small programs where the fee is somewhere around $550 for one program. So sometimes it is one program, sometimes it is two program. Mostly the accounting program is separate that you need to do before starting your real classes. So the fee for that program is $500 approximately. And it is a 1 month program that you can complete before starting your real classes in RRU. So it becomes a kind of foundation program. So you can complete this program, but even though the condition is there, still you can file for your visa before meeting this condition. And you can apply for visa before completing this program as well. But if you can complete this program successfully with 73% marks, in that case, it will again improve your visa chances because it shows your ability to complete that program. Because when you are completing a program with 73% marks, again, it is an addition in your learning ability. So all in all, I really like this program. It can be a great option, great alternate if you are going for international business or global business management or this kind of program or business management. So if you are coming from this kind of backgrounds, HR, so if you are coming from this kind of backgrounds, recently we secured three admissions at least with HR backgrounds for this program and business background as well. So this is a really good option. People do not know about it, but it can become a really great alternate to secure admission and to get visa as well. Many times it happens that students have really good IELTS score, everything is good, marks are good. Still they are going for a PG diploma or something, some bad program. So no need to go for any college or anything. If you can secure admission in RRU, it can become a really great option for you. And do not worry about the job opportunities in that area. Everything is good. We have discussion upon this part as well. So do not worry about job opportunities for your spouse, for yourself as well. You can easily survive there for 1 year. After that, you can move anywhere for your during your internship period and for your PG work permit as well. I hope this video was informative. If so, please like, share, comment. See you in next video.